Tiffany here with Years of Years, and it's This Day in Disney for August 20th. And to start off, we're heading to 1928 with the birth of a very special lady, Harriet Burns, who was actually born Harriet Tapp in San Antonio, Texas. And she was the first woman hired by Walt Disney in a creative capacity. So not as an office worker or anything like that, but for her creative talent and abilities. And she began her work in 1955 at the Disney Studios as a prop and set painter for the Mickey Mouse Club. So that was a lot of fun. And she ended up doing so much for especially the parks, but for Walt Disney Studios. She helped create the Sleeping Beauty Castle, and then New Orleans Square, the Haunted Mansion, and Pirates of the Caribbean, and much, much more for the theme parks, and also for the World's Fair attraction, the 1964-65 World's Fair. So she actually retired in 1986 after 31 years of great work. And after she retired, she actually went and became a fan community popular speaker. So she would go and speak at events, and I'm sure Disney fans like us just loved having her around to talk about her days at the Disney Studios. So Walt Disney actually featured her as well several times on The Wonderful World of Color, and he would have her on the show and show the things that she was making and creating, and the work she was doing. One of the things that I remember seeing her working on was with the Tiki Room and those amazing birds, and trying to get the birds' feathers to look realistic. And I'm pretty sure it was her idea to use cashmere, just like in Walt's sweaters or other sweaters, that cashmere really made the birds look real. So that's what they use. So anyway, really appreciate Harriet Burns' talent and her career with the Walt Disney Studios, and learning more about her. Next up on This Day in Disney, we're going to talk about another Disney cartoon. In 1932, Trader Mickey was released. And this cartoon reminds me so much of The Jungle Cruise, and so just right off from the beginning, there's so many elements that are like The Jungle Cruise, so you have to go watch it and tell me if you think the same. But basically, Mickey has a boat full of instruments that him and Pluto are trying to take across the waters, and they're actually raided by cannibals who take all their stuff and put them in a boiling pot of water or soup or whatever. But then they try stirring the soup with Mickey in it with a saxophone, and Mickey grabs that saxophone and starts playing it, and everything changes. And it's a good old fashioned song and dance, or actually a wild jam session to the song of the Dark Town Strutter's Ball. So that's the song that they play in there, and the cannibals and Mickey and Pluto are all dancing and having a big laugh and a lot of fun together, and it ends up being a really adorable cartoon. I enjoyed it, and you should go check it out. It was actually a spoof on the 1931 MGM film Trader Horn, directed, so this cartoon though, Trader Mickey, was directed by David Hand, and the whole time I've been talking about this, I've been trying so terribly not to say Trader Sam's, but like I said, it reminds me of The Jungle Cruise. So go check this cartoon out, and if you don't know about Harriet Burns, go look her up, and you could probably watch her on The Wonderful World of Color somewhere on YouTube, or maybe eventually on Disney Plus. That'd be really fun. So that's it for This Day in Disney, and I hope you're having a great day, and we will see you next time.